Okay, it's working. Hello everybody, Glitch Reaper here again. I'm still testing my 1.7.10 version of my mod pack, but I do have some news. I think I'm going to be showing the 1.10.2 version relatively soon, actually, as part of this, which includes, of course, a lot of cool new content just from vanilla Minecraft. But also, a lot of mods are totally new to that, and a lot of them are updated or seriously rehashed. So, there's going to be a whole lot of differences between this and 1.10.2, so, things happen. But hey, I'm definitely going to have fun with that either way, so, yeah, I'm good. I'm also aware that I don't have armor on, and I'm probably headed towards a very interesting situation, so yeah. I also see a mage right behind me. This reminds me, do I have one of those special items they drop? No, I do not. It's not just them, it's a lot of general enemies, actually. If you have mine Jekka 3, there's this thing that's literally called a thingy. I know, really? A thingy? But anyhow, that's what they call it. And it's useful for starting off the mod in the first place and doing other things with it. But they can be a bit dangerous if you want to fight the mages, so it's usually better to just wait until you just get one as a random drop. So I'm probably going to wait for that, but you never know. I might, actually have some special tricks that might be able to help out, so maybe I can get them at range. Yeah, I do have my summoning staff still. Oh, by the way, I did do the Petmas thing off camera here, so I do have a couple of interesting things. The Solstice Sword and the Solstice Leggings. They're both really good, although I do want to preserve these as long as possible, although I think they probably have good durability. Maybe. I'm thinking about that one. I'm probably actually going to be going into another dimension in a little while, so I'll probably wind up getting some armor from there. And, by the way, this iron ore, consider that double because I basically stole a smeltery worth of blocks from, actually double smeltery worth of blocks from several, from a couple of nearby villages. Because witchery is here, they are very frequent. It's like, as long as you have witchery, the villages are turned up, so yes, I have this much smeltery from a couple of towns. Oh, this reminds me, I still need to do the winter gifts, and this one I gotta be careful of. I'm gonna wait till I have really heavy armor. I think I can open it on any other day. But that one's always, let's just say it's always a bit of a party. Bad timing. Bad timing. Well, I'll keep you busy while I rest, so, yeah. Oh, he still figures out who did it. Oops. They count is me regardless. Okay. I know I recently had an experience where they gunned down a creeper and the creeper. Oh, he's stopped by a solid block. It's like a guardian beam from 1.8. Sweet. He can't get through this. He can't get through this. That's funny. Oh, he's stopped by a door. Oh, thanks, guys. Nice. Summon for the win. Oh my goodness sakes, yes, thank you, thank you. Did he drop the thing? He dropped leather, but did he drop the thingy? No, he did not. No, he did not. Well, I said it was a higher chance, didn't I? Unfortunately, that was not one of those times. And, these foods come from, that I nibbled there, they come from the, Crafting Pillars mod with, those Christmas trees I've been farming up on top of my hill. Again, I'm going to have like a bigger base on top of it this time. That's one of the reasons why I wanted to go to other dimensions. Is I'm trying, well, that, you know, just testing in general. And is that a pineapple? It looks like a pineapple. It's a tropical garden from Harvest Craft. Okay, for a while I thought it looked like a Tropicraft pineapple. And I was thinking, aren't they normally two blocks high? I was right, that was totally something different. Okay, that's good. Okay, anyhow, as I was going to say, I was wanting to get some good blocks from the ether, so I'm going to go there. Thing is, I'd previously gotten enough to build, like, several dimensional portals worth in the previous world, so I had that transferred. this included, like, raids and raids of Zephyrs on top of me, and they dropped glowstone dust. So I got enough to get a portal to Aether. I also got lots of lapis from Silex, which are these little fish swimming around in pools. I wonder if they're around in the pool around here. That's an interesting question. Because they give off lapis whenever you kill them. They're literally called lapis fish as an alternate name. So that kind of says something. And I really also have to go into one of the mining dimensions I've got access to, because I really need to get some dark gems so I can get started on evil craft sometime soon. And there's a chameleon that I'm pretty sure wasn't the one I hit before. Hello? Are there any Silex in this pool? Is it a bit too thin? I don't know, but maybe it's a bit too thin. Oh well. Anyhow, I'm going to be going towards the Aether now. Yeah, that was interesting. Oh, no. I was gonna open some of these, because I do need more resources. I kind of burnt out my supply of certain things, like diamonds. In fact, I should probably... don't mind El Cheapo there. It literally is what it is. It's a solid stone pickaxe that I made with tinkers. It's just for the purpose of mining soft rocks, like cobblestone. And because it's made of cobblestone, I can therefore get a lot more of them for cheap while I'm mining. So it's a pretty good little combo. I figured it would be you.
Good tidings I bring.
Come on, scan. I need to scan you even if I die. Oh, I'm probably gonna die. He's very powerful. Gotta get them off at least. Okay. Got one of them off at the last moment. But since I've already set my point here, I really need to find a way if I can, like, get rid of these somehow, like... I need to find out if I can, like, undo that with the configs, because... probably a good idea. That guy is super powerful. My, summoning focus doesn't regenerate fast enough for this guy. And he puts down so much, so much green fire. Oh, gosh. May not be able to, Wait. Do I have the thing to get rid of stuff? Let's see. Showcase crafting. These are all ones I've also got, because as I do those presents from the Christmas trees, they will, as I was showing before the world had to reset, you can get all sorts of variations, and there's one of these that's good for getting rid of stuff. It's called a trash pillar, and it looks really cool when you open it. Oh, he definitely knows I'm here. Okay, maybe if he loses sight for a while, I can ambush him later. No, I got an interesting spot to store these for a while. I just remember I've got these here. Wait, I can turn these into bone meal? I didn't know that before. It's the first time I've tried crafting anything well. Okay, so they are of use, even if you. Well, that was a first. Okay, this guy, maybe I should have created a side door. Because I do want to kill him. I really, really do. Come on, lock on. Why won't you lock on? I can't even hit him. What the? What's going on? Oh, there's a glitch. Sometimes you can't get squat for a while. I'm gonna have to log off and then log back on. Just a moment. Okay, Glitch Reaper here. I'm back on, and I'm about to craft one of my favorite alternative weapons. An iron spear. Well, I'd go for diamond, but I don't have any right now. Well, as long as it's worth bone meal, I'll go with that. First time that came up. Thing is, these have a little reach, and they still combo well. Just need to destroy him fast. Nope. I do not have enough stuff to really fight this guy at full power right now like I used to. But at least it's not too big of a deal. Okay. Got some of those charges. But if only the fire brigade could be fast enough here, because, kind of left the place a bit of a mess. It's being torched. It's definitely being torched. So I got Krampus. And it's definitely after Christmas season, I know. But, wow, this spreads like crazy. Seriously? Dude, that's a little excessive. I really need to make sure it doesn't go uphill too much. Oh, the trees. Please, trees. I'm definitely a fire brigade right now, because I want to save the trees. Much as I can. Oh wow, this is super fast spread, but at least it punches out. It's just as quick as normal fire, so I can just... is there any other place burning on this one? No. Go on. If I can take out enough of it, I can gutter it out. Okay, can I gutter out this fire? And, obviously I don't need to destroy every one of those. It's just a little demon appearance, not too big of a deal. Of which worse, Oh, I can't punch it on this side, it has to be on that side. Oh, come on, let me hit. Okay. There's one left on the top of the tree. Can I get to it without flying? I can now, just saying, but I'd rather not. I'd rather just see if I can jump hit it. Gotcha. There we go. Jump hit it nicely. Okay. So there should be no more remnants of fire. I have more of these to go, but at least I scanned one of them, because now I can use them as a minion. Those were behemoths. So they're from Lycanites Mobs, and they're particularly big and powerful, so yeah.
Ugh, here's your present.
Nice. I got a treat. More glowstone and diamonds. Amber cake. Oh, those are great. They apply a speed boost. So that's pretty sweet. Oh, I made one of these soul stones in case I can bind a new friend. Since I'm around the plains-like areas, I can get a Vento Raptor. I've seen them around here, I know they show up. They are cool. They can kind of glide, so... They can't exactly fly, but they can glide. And you can use them as a mount, so you can ride along on them. These, you have to use your Soul Gazer as a catalyst. It does not get used up. You need 4 Ender Pearls and 4 Diamonds. So, kind of expensive compared to normal, but I've gotten several of the mobs showing up here dropping diamonds. I mean, dropping Ender Pearls, sorry. But the trees have been giving me diamonds because of the presents once in a while.
Ugh, here's your present.
Ooh, I actually kind of need some coal because I just used mine up to make a lot of torches. Which reminds me, I should probably make more torches. Ooh, it's an angry tree.
Good tidings I bring for me.
See, I've already scanned you. Or not. Yes, I have. Yes, I have. Okay. Time to chop. Good thing that counts as an axe. Ooh. I'll just use these up right now, thank you very much. Ooh. Sundown. Just trying to use up the remainder of my presents. I gathered all those in one giant. One large winter gift box, anyhow. After I use these up, I'm totally going to the ether. I need an ether break. Whoa, what just happened? Okay, I'm back. Technical difficulties. Crash happens. Word of advice. Sometimes release these doors, and Tinker's Construct Maddox seem to not necessarily agree with each other, apparently. Because the last thing I remember, I was just closing the door while holding my Maddox, so that could happen. Okay, back to the remaining opening, I guess? Just gotta be careful. Oh wait, I was gonna put on those pants. That's something I was thinking that, yeah, it probably would help, because I think I'll be able to get to the ability to repair them before they run out. Although what would be really amusing is if I suddenly found out, you know, I don't really need this right now. I'll probably... I mean, I know it'll gain... Well, wait, how close is it on experience? Oh, it's actually kinda close, but this definitely has more whoa! How does it have that much? I thought it had less than that before it started doing its bonus damage. Okay. Wow, this really is a great sword. Okay, thank you, inventory pets. Oh, and I gotta take care of these, because if I lose them, there is no way I can get them back right now. It's a very seasonal thing, and the season is over, so I'll just put that there for now, I guess. So I'm gonna wear these. I really hope they're unbreakable, but I don't know if they are. This has special bonus damage. Every time the Solstice Sword hits, it deals an additional 9 damage after that, and it keeps stacking. It says it has a cooldown after 3 seconds of inactivity, so if you go not whacking creatures for 3 seconds, it goes back to its base damage, which is apparently pretty high. So it says plus 18.75. Of course, I think that takes into account the sharpness. It also has Smite, so it has some enchantments you normally don't see together, because otherwise they conflict. And this is from inventory pets from whenever I was having Petmas. So this was a special gift, and again, if I lose this for any reason, if I have to, like, if I lose this world, it is gone. Like, completely gone. So I will just lose it, because I have no way of getting it back. There's, like, literally no way. It was a one-time thing. So this is a good bonus, and it will probably help me out quite a bit, because it deals a lot of damage, and these guys are suddenly everywhere. If I attack one to do the rest attack, well, one thing I can do is see if it summons somebody, and it's right on top of them.
Ugh, here's your present.
But I get a treat instead, which is nice in and of itself, actually. Hey, you, would you like to, possibly...
Ugh. Here's your present.
Emerald? Nice, I'm getting all sorts of goodies. And some of these will be useful for so many mods.
Here's your present.
It's like, just by doing this, the luck for this is through the roof. Because every time I do this, the guy's like just standing there, and it's refusing to summon the monsters. Did I just get blaze rods? Oh, I so need that. I so need that.
Ugh. Here's your present.
And more. This is a good streak.
Good tidings,
Wendigo.
I bring for me.
Calls it bitterness, but it's Wendigo. Oh, I can't turret him into the other guy. Yet. Maybe I can get him to follow me. Come on, I want you to do this. I know I can take you out, but I just want to see if you could fight each other. Come on, over here. Hit him. Come on, you know you wanna. Hit him. I like watching mob battles, especially if I can just set him up spontaneously. Oh, this is ironic, he's using ice magic. Oh, come on, do it. Spontaneous mob battle fight! It's a mage versus Gooderness, which is basically a super Wendigo. Okay. Okay, apparently the Wendigo wins, but he took a lot of damage first. At least it looked like it. Is this one of the, yeah, I think this is the thing where I can't damage him. Nope, I could damage him. Take him out very quickly, for that matter. Okay, Frostfire. I'm gonna have to whip you out. Ooh, Reaver. I need to scan them. Scanning time. Oh, that was a big shot. Okay, need to run. Yeah. Oh, hit all the things. But at the same time, I still got it. I was surrounded. The bands are good, but they're not enough to take all that down. And as before, now that I know that that's a thing, honestly, I did not know that you could grind those down that well. Special ability card. Thank you. Are there any more? Syria became a winter wonderland so fast. Oh my goodness sakes, I need to use this up. Okay, I think I have that particular seed. But I need to use this up. Area of area damage. Area card. Oh, I just learned it. I literally just learned it, so I have an extra. Anybody need one of these for their custom pets? Anybody? We'll trade. Because I have an extra one now. It's one I cannot use. So, Yeah, I can't learn that because I already have that, so apparently you can't stack that way. Ooh, need more room-ish. Need to do a lot of... Yeah, I put some of this in here, that's right. I'm trying to resort these so that I can at least get them spread out where I don't have anything super stuffed right now. Not too big of a deal, but still. Just, ooh, charges. Nice. I just put some wintry stuff in here for now. Clear out a few slots. Okay, I should have enough to keep opening these. Okay. And it's getting dark again. Oh, really? You again? Well, that was a quick dispatch. Night vision! Nice. Whenever I get to custom pets, this is gonna be cool. And you may notice that I'm not going into that dimension anymore, unfortunately because of certain problems I had to let go of that mod. It was a cool idea, but in the end, it had some issues.
Ugh. Here's your present.
Those blocks of iron? Why, yes. Yes, they are. Whole blocks of iron. Okay. Are there any mages left that I might impose upon to assist me? I got cow dipper. Goodbye. Thank you. I heard a... Oh, I got a creeper head. I don't know if that sound was for the creeper head or not. Are there any more mages? Any more mages? No. Okay, Oh, I got the thingy. I can start my Jekka 3 now. Cool. In fact, I think I also needed the emerald for it, so... Yeah, this'll work. My opening presents has been working
good
very well.
Good tidings I bring for me.
Oh, this was a super. Was a super. Was a super. Changing... Ooh. Bulwark Burger. Oh. Okay, I can use up another card. When you got something usable or placeable, that's always a good thing to do right before you grab stuff. Okay. I'm probably gonna need this for the next few creatures anyhow, so... Yeah.
Good tidings I bring.
Santa Claus, late. Whoa, cannot see worth a darn right now. Cannot see at all. This is what I mean by them giving us so many different types of resources. Like, seriously. Okay, I need to go in and throw some things into my chest again. Because this is just kind of insane. Oh, snow, I can group that. I can turn this into iron and then put this back here with my other iron. There we go. I know this is a little haphazard right now, but I'll be able to organize stuff more later. And now I just need to get things out of my inventory. Thunder charges. Frosty fur. Cotton seeds could go over here. I'll grab that later. Okay, because I know I'm reserving these blocks for whenever I go to the ether, because I'm going to need a lot of building blocks. Seriously, it's gonna be a lot of blocks.
Ugh, here's your present.
I backed up into it. Okay, some extra glowstone dust and stuff. Nice.
Good tidings I bring for me.
Obviously, that one with all the extra health was probably an infernal.
Good tidings
not this time,
I
buddy.
Bring for me.
Not this time. No. I am not letting you trail fire everywhere again. Sorry.
Ugh. Here's your present.
Ender pearls.
Riot! Forest parasites!
I have an interesting idea having to do with this event, which spontaneously showed up. Holding on to this for a while. I think this is about the time to reveal it. I'm getting all over the place here because of stuff just happening to me very quickly. But I totally need to organize this better. I know, but it's, again, I need to do it like, do I have any gunpowder? Okay, I'll just, again, I have to redistribute these chests a bit. See, it's not exactly the easiest thing to have to deal with suddenly. Okay, that cleared out some space. I've got a root riot on my hands. I was originally thinking of using this soul stone on a Ventoraptor to go to the ether, but during a root riot, you can also find shamblers, or at least they come up more easily. In fact, there they are. And I want one as a pet. I've never had a shambler before. I really want one. I need to get a stray. I'll have that out just in case. Well, actually, I can tame them first and then scan them. It doesn't matter who controls them or why whenever you scan them. Oh, here's a loner. Oh, right at the last one. Nice, nice. Okay, he's mine. He's totally mine. Yes! I can make him, inactive for now, and then I can handle the rest. Uh-oh. And here's the rest. Okay. Where were you? Knocked you out of the air. Nice. Okay, there's more. I'm having a real riot on my hands, and it's based on roots, apparently. Okay. Root riot is continuing. All I wanted to do is go to another dimension. But is that happening now? No. By the way, most of the plant types, etc., in Lycanites Mobs are weak to axes, but this sword just deals so much damage. That paralysis effect is kind of annoying, but it's not really too bad whenever you have this much oomph. Okay, I need... Okay, they're everywhere. They're genuinely everywhere. I think I cleared them out. That tree had snow on it from that whole event. Oh my goodness, that's funny. Winds up snowing on the tree. Oh gosh. Well, in salute to that, I'll have a tree biscuit. There you go. I have a tree biscuit. Okay. As I cleared out all of them, I should be able to just take my pet back out again. My new leafy friend. And I'm going to have to figure out what I'd like to call a shambler. Because I had a name in mind, but I'm trying to remember what it was. I really did. I had one in mind. I just don't remember what it was now. Oh, and it does automatically count whenever you tame one like that. Okay, that's nice to know. I've had that happen before and wondered whether or not that was actually the case. No, wait a moment. I scanned these before with that previous root riot. That's right. That's why I was doing this plan. This happened before, and I was thinking, well, if this happens again, I'll be ready. Okay, so that was what happened. Okay. So I'm good now. And I can sort out all this stuff at some point. But I was going to introduce my plan for going to the ether. As I said before, I kind of had a previous event in the previous world. And I was wanting to get ready to do that. So I was going to explain some of the different dimensions in my mod pack that I can go to in this version. Some of these will also be around in the 1.7, in the 1.10.2 version at some point. Now, the ether. Here's the old school ether portal. Made of glowstone instead of obsidian, but in the same standard Minecraft organization. Although, admittedly, in this version, I think they'd already made it where the obsidian portals could be of different sizes. So this one's actually a bit more strict than what vanilla is now. Here is something you'll use for the different dimensions of Cape World 2, as well as this follow-up in 1.10.2, which is a cavern. Now, there's a different selection of dimensions between the two versions. It's still by the same author. It's still essentially the same mod evolved. But 1.10, things changed, so he kind of went with the flow. I think it's Japanese, because his name's Kagari, I think. This is the portal for the Shadow World, and it's made of lapis. Again, having lapis fish nearby really made this easy whenever I was preparing this before, but again, world issue, so I decided to recapture a few materials. Now, as to what to start some of these off with, well, the ether is kind of familiar to some players because it's not lit with flint and steel, it's charged up with a bucket of water. Yep, just pour it in, And there you go. Makes some interesting sounds, don't it? And while I'm charging up dimensions, here is the one for, well, actually, let me do another one instead first, because it's kind of like a familiar item. This shadow lighter is essentially flint and gold. It's like a flint and steel, only it's flint and gold, so yeah. And you won't be using it very much, so the durability won't matter too terribly much. So I'm not as worried about losing those as some other things, especially when I've already lit the portal now. Although if I decide to move these later, that might become important. Now, when it comes to this, however, you have to use an ender chest. At least I think I do it in one of the upper corners. Yeah, there we go. I got an achievement for it. Now, these have an interface, and they actually have a portal inventory. Like, you can stuck stuff in the portal as if it was a chest. Isn't that something? Dimension regeneration, I'm really hoping that that continues in the 1.10 version. I haven't tried it yet. But it allows you to literally regenerate the whole dimension, so it acts as a regenerative mining dimension. You go in, you mine like crazy, and things happen. Oh, and it has additional customization, because it has vein customize. Okay. What can I do here? Oh, wow. This has the full list. Does it have everything modded, too? I'm not sure. It has a lot of the standard ones. I'm really curious whether or not this is truly compatible with, like, all modded ores. So that's something I will definitely have to check into. It's saying customized, but I think the default option is for it to do other things. Now, what I was going to do is I was going to go into the ether, so I may wind up cutting this episode into multiple parts again. Because I've kind of lost track of how far things have gone because of the crashes and other things I had to go in and out for, so we'll see. Anyhow, here's my first jump into the ether, so wish me luck, everybody. Probably gonna get my first major armor set from here, unless I decide to... I'm just gonna go in.